is that Joshua Pacio beat himself in that match.
And he did just that. Jared Brooks smashed him in the face as well, but Joshua Pacio needs to get out of his own head in this fight here against Mansur Malachiev. Malachiev is so good. Looks like he's touched up on the eye, though, from that big right hook. He might be suffering a little bit of damage in that left eye.
And he shoots a shot. Takedown does Malachiev.
That's that long-distance shot I was talking about with Malachiev with no setup. Pacio is just too crafty for that. He's going to have to put those shots behind something.
Beautiful takedown defense by the Passion early on in the first.
Well, this is a big confidence builder for him because he talked about it with Jared Brooks. Ooh, good jab landed there, though. But he talked about defending that takedown with Jared Brooks and how his confidence was a little shaken at the end, and he started planting his feet and focusing only on that.
Yeah, this is Joshua Pacio's first fight with the new camp, Lions Nation MMA. As you can see, he's got teammates Edward Folion and Jeremy Pacatiu in his corner. Since leaving Team Lakai, they went to the States and did a lot of training out there in New Mexico and California.
I don't know if he was trying to play possum or if he was, I don't know. Unorthodox his movements.
No, his knee buckled. It looked like it buckled when he came in on that other shot.
I wonder if Pacio's going to pick up the pace.
And Pacio immediately goes after the leg. Something's wrong with Malachiev.
Malachiev telling Olivier Cost he's fine and he's able to continue. So this one, some adversity for Mansur Malachiev here.
What happens with those low leg kicks? It kind of damages the nerve, and it just takes a little bit of time just to get that feeling back and to get your feet underneath you.
I don't know if it was that or if he stepped in at one point in time and the knee actually buckled on a faint step in of a shot, maybe tore a ligament or something. But he knows he desperately needs to get this to the ground now.
Going for a takedown, a single leg as Malachiev trying to get it here. Pacio looking to hold him off, and he gets the takedown, does Malachiev.
Good chain wrestling on that. Joshua Pacio had great defense initially on that, a good sprawl, and Malachiev was able to just turn the corner on that and earn the takedown.
Gritty decision-making process right there for Mansur Malachiev. It was imperative that he got this fight to the ground. Now it's imperative that Joshua Pacio gets back up to his feet and starts to test that leg again. Like you said, Rich, on the walk, once Mansur Malachiev gets you down, it is almost impossible to get him off of you. He's so top-heavy. He's got such good grappling.
Both men are cut. There is a cut above the left eye of Pacio. And a cut underneath the left eye of Malachiev. Under 2 minutes left.
Pacio's trying to pop out onto his hip, get that knee shield going on, create a little bit of space. Trying to push off the hips to get Malachiev off of him. Malachiev wisely reaches under, lifts the leg up, slides back into the full guard. Crafty grappling here early on by Malachiev in this first round.
But just tenacity by Malachiev, who is 31 years of age, undefeated 11-0 with 9 finishes, to get that takedown against the former strawweight MMA world champion, Joshua Pacio.
Rich, you seem concerned with something. What are you seeing here?
It's just that if something is wrong with Malachiev's leg, he's got to improve his position past this guard. This body head work is not going to get it done. They're going to start this second round back on their feet. And if he's not able to take penetration steps the way that he needs to earn these takedowns, you saw that initial shot, he typically depends on that. He was able to get the second takedown, though. This could be a tough night for Malachiev.
But he's got the fight where he wants it right now. Applying pressure here from that top position. Wise for Pacio just to sit here and sort of stall him out and sort of wait for that second round to start.
I mean, this is going for a guillotine. I don't ever find it wise to stall out a match. I'm always looking for the finish.
A guillotine choke attempt for Joshua Pacio.
This is going to be a tough one to land on Malachiev. This is his chokes are his specialties.
Pacio has 9 submissions to his credit. That'll end the first. One championship home to the world's greatest martial artist.
I felt that one from the commentary booth.
Pacio wisely going to the leg with the leg kicks, forcing Malachiev to be very light on that lead leg. There's a shot easily defended by the former champion, Pacio. Nice shot landed on the with the right hand on the exit.
Spinning back kick there by Malachiev. Another spinning back fist, though, by Malachiev. Look at that. Spinning back kick and a spinning back fist.
Dangerous position for Pacio.
Guillotine choke here.
Look at Pacio scrambling, defending like he's done his homework.
Pacio talked about how he had studied that Malachiev fight against Jeremy Miado, and he talked about the length of Malachiev's arms and knew how dangerous they were, so I'm sure they spent plenty of time in camp in these bad positions.
Knees to the head of a grounded opponent are perfectly eagle here in one. Pacio able to utilize one just now, but Malachiev reverses the position and gets back into guard. Needs to be a little bit of urgency here for Pacio, though. Needs to get back up to his feet, but when you scramble, that's when Malachiev starts to catch you. If you leave an arm extended, if you leave your neck out, he's wrapping you up for those chokes. So Pacio needs to be very careful here with turning back to his feet.
Yeah, I talked about that on my keys, is capitalizing on the scrambles. You know, Malachiev works best when he's in those scrambles. Being in this position here, he's in my opinion, he's not that classic ground and pounder from the guard. He won't get it done from this position. He's got to threaten guard passes, improving his position, and create those scrambles so that Pacio exposes the back, leave his neck out, and gives Malachiev the chance to grab it. But like you said, Mitch, there should be some urgency in Pacio's corner here, because you know, you don't want to sit on the bottom of this game just slowly taking punch after punch and accumulating damage and losing a squeaked out victory on the scorecards like that.
Malachiev certainly bringing a workmanlike effort here, despite the fact that he is cut underneath his left eye and he is looking to pound away upon Joshua Pacio as we are at the midway point of the second round.
But Pacio is a tricky grappler off his back. He does have some submissions on his record. He likes to attack with triangles. He likes to go for arm bars. He's got a very active guard. You can see him trying to open up his legs and slide out to the hips and look for sweeps and reversals. It's going to be hard because Malachiev is so top heavy and so strong in this position. He's going to have to do something extraordinary. Put his feet on the hips, really try to explode off, create that space to get that movement, because you don't want to sit here for another 100 seconds with Malachiev punching in the face.
No, but he's grabbing the back of Malachiev's head half the time, so even though he's kind of working an open guard or shield guard, or maybe putting a foot on the hip and, you know, almost transitioning to some sort of butterfly or whatever, he's still grabbing the back of the head, which is subconsciously pulling his opponent down, so he's not creating the space that he needs to either get up or reverse or whatever he needs to do.
Malachiev did say, my wrestling is on a whole different level. We'll see if he can defend against it. Well, I think so far in the first two rounds, that answer has been given to us, as Malachiev been successful in his takedown attempts.
Nice pass and nice recovery by Pacio there. Those are the opportunities that Malachiev cannot let just slide by it.
Malachiev started training wrestling from the age of 8, competed in combat sambo. Finding a way on the body of Pacio.
Malachiev uses his hips really well, so when Pacio does try to frame and create a little bit of space by putting his feet on the hips of Malachiev, Malachiev shifts his hips from side to side so that Pacio is not able to really get some leverage and properly push up on the hips. Malachiev is a problem to deal with here. Looks like we're going to see a third and final round in this strawweight battle as Pacio starts to smile at the camera, knowing full well he's getting beat up on the ground, Rich.
Tie.
It's a hold. So Pacio, if he has a massive round here to the judges, he can send the fight. Looking for a takedown is Malachiev, and he gets it again.
Yeah, an early takedown, too, mind you, Ray. 4 minutes, 40 seconds to go with Mansur Malachiev on top of you. It's not good, but there's a choke here.
Guillotine choke attempt for Joshua Pacio.
Pacio squeezing for all he's worth.
Oh, boy, that might be deep. That might be deep, gentlemen. Can Pacio finish the submission attempt?
Looks like the tension might have been released. Now it's just kind of a placeholder. Malachiev is going to drive that shoulder into the body of Pacio to relieve a little bit of tension. Choke is still there.
I believe that Olivier Cross called a catch here, and keep in mind that on the judging criteria, that is scored as a near finish. And so that's our highest scoring category. This is going to weigh heavily for Pacio. Talking about this being scored.
And we're hearing them.
Oh, no. Keep going.
So they are going to continue. As a minute 10 has elapsed here in this third round, as they continue to go head-to-head on the ground here. Malachiev on top, on the bottom, Pacio. There's a left over the top by Malachiev. And as you see, as we see that Malachiev just staying busy, he's trying to really pick up and land some significant strikes on the ground. Malachiev pound into the left side of the body of Pacio. And now Olivier Cost will bring them to their feet. And this is an opportunity for Pacio to go to work.
Yeah, even though Pacio caught that choke there, Olivier Cost caught a catch, and that's a near finish. I'm not sure that the top side opponent control, even though that's not round superiority. He needs to get something done here just to ensure that he doesn't have any kind of question of winning this match.
We are approaching the midway point of this third round. Pacio has to get busy here.
It's those time strikes that make Pacio so dangerous, even in this late part of the round in the fight. He can counter-strike so well, and he still carries power with it deep into the round. You don't want to give Pacio too many opportunities to touch your chin, because he'll put you out. But Mansur Malachiev is fighting a very smart fight. I would expect another takedown to come pretty soon.
I would like to see Pacio throwing that jab, feinting that jab before he throws that kick. These leg kicks coming downstairs, they're great. But he doesn't want to give Malachiev the opportunity to just grab that leg and hit the ground again for the last part of this round. He's got to disguise these things behind something.
Time! Malachiev, let's go!
Olivia Cost is monitoring both guys. He wants to see them mix it up a little bit more. 90 seconds left in the fight.
That's what Pacio told us he wanted to do. He wanted to really beat up that lead leg and set up those power shots with the hands. He stuck to it for as long as he's been on the feet, but Mansur Malachiev has just been able to control so many minutes on the ground.
Spinning back miss that misses for Malachiev. Pacio got out of the way.
See, Rich, you're gonna see that maybe in the referee, in the judge's eyes, that the damage was caused by the leg kicks that we saw in the first round, the near finish of the choke in the third. So maybe Pacio, because the judges don't have really the replays that we get to see in the camera angles.
Yeah, and Pacio's done a great job of defending these takedowns as well. Just keep in mind that the guard position is a neutral position. This is not a way of displaying ground control. You get points for the takedown itself, but once you're in the guard, then it's a neutral position, and from there, you have to mount damage.
See, Malachiev is now in the guard of Pacio. Pacio
and also in a choke.
Yeah,
right.
A guillotine choke here for the former strawweight world champion.
Another arm in guillotine here, but this one's arm in, so it's going to be a little bit harder for Pacio to get the leverage that he wants, especially with the shoulder position of Malachiev driving in there as he gives the thumbs up to us and the fans that he's okay.
Malachiev doing the Hulk Hogan here, but you need to show something that you're trying to get out of that position.
Well, Malachiev faced adversity.
By unanimous decision, Joshua